Look how soft that is. That's because you've mixed it over medium speed.
And is those the peak things that people talked about?
And it's so the glossiness is because it was medium.
Yeah, medium speed.
That's lovely. Right time.
And also, if you're making souffles, you can go a little bit softer than that. And bear in mind, when that now rises, it'll rise beautifully and smooth. Mm. If the egg white's too hard, it goes all crunchy and it tends to break. So it's really interesting that you just... And I made that 10 minutes ago, and look, it hasn't broken at all.
Gorgeous.
Now, pavlova, we had a bit of vinegar.
Oh, now what are you adding in there?
Yeah, and then we had a bit of cornflour or arrowroot starch.
This is like alchemy.
No, it just... It just sorts the proteins. It holds the proteins together.
You're like really a wizard.
No. It's just cooking 50 years, 40 years.
Yeah, but you don't know all these things. I just thought it was a bit of sugar and a bit of egg white whizzed up.
No. Touch of vanilla.
No.
Heaven forbid.
I know, it's good to know.
And then just fold these in. You'll see, as you fold them in, you just need to look at how soft that is.
And it's amazing.
And that's all you need to do. Now, some chefs put it in a deep tin. I just tend to use my free form as well. So you put, because you've got a disc on there, see that disc, which we've put a bit of pencil, in it goes, into the centre.
And then how do you get it into a nice shape?
Right, what you do is just bring that out, and then with a palette knife or a spoon...
So you know when it's in a good shape, because...
You just move it around.
So
you
run off the edge.
Yes, you just keep moving it around, and as you go around, the whole thing comes out to the edge.
And you want a little dip in the middle.
Yes, you do, and then what you do is you just do that in the middle. And you spread that around.
Oh, that's very good, isn't it? Look at that. A little whirly-woo.
Right, now, the filling. Roasted pears, I've got to get moving on because we've only got a minute. So, I'm going to put the pears on top. So, we'll just chop these into... Let's move that out of the way so you see that.
How long did you cook it for, sorry?
About an hour and 15 minutes. And then you leave the oven. You leave it to set in the oven, OK? So, here I've just got the...
That just cream?
Yeah, that's just double cream. Now, this is let down slightly because we are on telly, but if I had a touch of lemon juice for that, that would just tighten that up nicely. See, like that. Look at that, you see? And then on it goes. Now, this is a bit loose, this one, but you'll see how... Look at that. Now, if you can pull this on, OK...
It's going to run off the end, isn't it?
Yeah, it will do because we are just...
Under the lights.
Under the lights. And you put a bit of pear on there as well. You pop it onto there, and then a little bit of lemon goes on top as well, and then a little bit of lemon juice on top, and that just tightens the cream. I know we've got to go to a hard count, so I thought you can have a little bit of a taste.
Don't give the secret away.
Come on. Don't worry. Have a little taste. It's nice and forks there. On actual fact, Holly, I've got your spoon here. That's your spoon.
Ah, you know what I'm like.
Okay, a few more raspberries on top. They go like that.
Hang on, I can't get in there.
I love the finesse.
Hey, it's about eating it.
That's gorgeous.
The end result. But you'll just see that. Then if you can put lemon juice on there in the fridge, leave it for an hour, even better.
Thank you.
Bill, thank you very much.
That's really good.
Absolutely
stunning.
That's
like no meringue I've ever tasted. Oh.